Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Sound 103. Last week, we docked in port. The men took a two-week leave. And now, August 20th, it's a Sunday. Men are well recuperated from the rest and have just got back from early church service. We have new orders. We're to sail. English coast. Nothing defined clearly yet. This is an intelligence raid, they say, though. We're not supposed to scout anything. We're just supposed to go out there and sit there. BF-16. And I'm going to change the rules a little bit. I don't want those. Don't want that either. Figure it out myself. Thank you. I'll leave the unrealistic sensors on, though, just because it lets me hear things farther away. And that's just kind of nice for finding stuff to do. Because I found that, without it, yeah, it's more realistic, but it's also really boring. So we have 16, that should be straight to the channel again. We'll take it about two-thirds speed. Anyway, a lot of hubbub going on the radios. Not much is quite certain. There's some talk of a dispute between us and Poland. Nothing solid yet, though. Just a lot of talk. So probably just wind up like the other two times we go out to sea and sat there, came back. I doubt we'll fire anything. Anyway. Nice loading screen. El Shaba del Undersebot. Bethel Shaba. Bethel Shaba? Sandrona. Bethel Shaba. Bethel Shaba. Bethel. Bethel. I'm trying to read this. I don't know if I've got it right. I don't think I have it. Unterseeboot. Sie Unterseeboot. Anyway, whatever. I'm just trying to speak German poorly. So, what time is it? We're getting out. September 9th. Whoa. Okay. It took some time to get everything. Well, I was under the impression it started on the date that it said. So we've taken quite a leave, too. We have to get to BF-6. When did all this happen? Come on. There goes my engaging storyline and plot. Alright, screw it. So, new storyline. The reason we're so late to the damn war is because stupid hole we poked in the U-boat when we scraped that merchant ship took about a week to patch up. And BF-16 is right there. And no, I'm not gonna go directly in between there. So we'll go up this way. Try and give England the reach around right about there. That's weird. Could have sworn it would dump us out on, like, the whatever. Ah well, enjoy those lights for the last time, boys. Thank God we finally got something to do. So we'll head up here to the Nordsee. Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and ignore our original objective because our original objective is stupid. Because I know the location of convoys. We'll go see if we can't find anyone over here. If we can't, then we'll head up that way, and then we'll head that way. Just see if we can catch anyone straying too far from home. Shift gesichtet. No, whatever. Let's get out there, boys. Zero, 6-8. I do think the hydrophone still draws things, which is helpful because it's good for getting a bearing, or getting your bearing on the hydrophone, which can just be kind of hard. I'm kind of popping in and out every now and then around the harbor just to make sure we don't hit anybody. It's not only would that be embarrassing, but it would also look kind of stupid. So we're starting on the 9th, we'll go 7th, so we'll go to 6th, we'll go to September 16th. We'll position ourselves off grid AN55, unless no enemy forces are present, in which case then we'll proceed on to Bravo Foxtrot 16. And we'll probably go around this way, just because I've had bad experiences in shallow waters with destroyers. During training, of course. Definitely not in any war that hasn't happened yet. No, the war's not even... I don't think the war's started yet. Like, let's just break character for a second. I thought it started on the 11th. It could have been on the 9th, though. I don't really remember. I know we'll get a radio message. If it does start. So, I don't know. Doesn't look like we haven't done nothing yet. There's not much has been done yet. I think we've just pissed them off. So, first sunrise of our voyage. Everyone doing well? Yes? BBC. I didn't know the British Broadcasting Corporation supported U-boats. Oh yes, and I fired a few, I transferred out a few of our crew members to better positions for them. And by that I mean I saved some rooms so that everyone can rest or be on duty now. So that, you know, no one's going to die of exhaustion. Pop this guy on watch once we get up there. Or once we get, out to... in 5-6, when we'll really need to be on good lookout for any type of shipping. And make sure we're heading at a head standard. Give me those reports, Chief. Oh, I can just get them here. Good fuel. Everything looks good. Radio message. Message. Convoys north of Brest may be attacked if escorted by French or by French and British forces. Right. Well. Northern and Brest, off Brest. If escorted. I'll apply those same directives to AN55. Also, if we're fired upon, I will return fire. Operator under presumption of English hostility. More messages. Foxtrot 17. puts them right there. Is Bravo Foxtrot always above? No. Just, 1 and 2 are the real places. I'd love to get out of port earlier, but apparently that scratch took more time for the engineer than, we thought. Who else is that? MacDapper. She's sinking, apparently. The Canadians have gotten mad at us. They've stopped saying sorry and started sending warships. It's moderately terrifying what Canada doesn't want to forgive you. It's like September 11th will come along soon, and we'll find out if I've been sorely mistaken all these years. These are very calm waters, though. I couldn't have asked for much better weather for hunting in. I do hope it stays the same. Up on the 9th. On the 16th, we have 5 days left. Alright. We've entered Area 5-6. Time to swap out that crewman. There we go. Someone specialized for it.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin.
Position on. I do wish I had a barometer, because then I could tell how the weather would change. Alright. Actually. Alright then, let's keep going. We'll drop down right about here. Ooh, that looks like a ship. We'll dive to periscope depth. Go ahead slow. For that long. However long that might have been. Pop that guy back up on the watch. On the surface. Get on with it. Right. All good. Another message. Someone sunk something.
Neuer Funkspruch, Herr Kaloin.
Yeah, the audio glitches out if you go too fast. So you two abort Portsmouth, proceed to Alpha 9962. Alright. Let's see what that means. Just in the reminding Portsmouth. Somewhere around here. Now they're gonna go over here and mine Bristol. Right about here-ish, I guess. Their answer will probably get shot back real quick, but I'm paying extra attention to the radio messages today. Transmit to Mr. Churchill. It's like a British steamer, Ferby. Save the crew if you please. I do remember that's an actual historical transmission. It was, Otto Krimscher, if I remember correctly. Auto something. It was the top German U-boat ace, if I remember correctly. And, basically sends Churchill Now they're relaying the message around. And, basically taunting the British, telling them to save the crew if they could. I don't know if they did. Be interesting to know. Joylet. It's like a really... The people there are happy, even though they can see the conditions are kind of shitty. Is my pun bad enough? No? Alright. Go for a quick dunk. Nothing. Back up on there for you. Yeah. I'm doing the dunk to submerge the hydrophone so that we can get, sound readings. Wow, that's why we're going so damn slow. Sun contact, merchantman, medium speed, closing bearing 03. Oop. Alright, erase those two. Compass. Oh, wrong one. Projector. From basically north. No, wait, that's not how I want to do it. I want it to be... from you. Zero. Alright.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Auftauchen.
Auftauchen. Auftauchen. Vorne oben 10, hinten kommen auf auf 5.
Surface the boat. Going crew to position. Once we're surfaced. I want the flak, not the flak, the artillery cannon ready to fire once we hit that surface. Gun crew to the deck gun. Deck gun.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin.
Hold your fire.
Feuer einstellen. Jawohl, Herr Kaloin.
Medium range.
Feuer über mittlere Distanz. Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Auf Wasserlinie zielen.
And fire the waterline. Let's see if we can't find us a merchant ship. Move along this route for 2 or 3 minutes.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin.
Periscope depth. Merchant medium speed, closing bearing 325. That could be anywhere, damn it. I got a regiment medium speed closing bearing 325. Means we're almost right on him. Need to get that rate of change set down there. So it could be right up there. Tap the boat. We need to get eyes on him first, then we'll focus on shooting him. Crap, get the men on the deck gun. Well, I don't know how he snuck up on us. I personally don't care.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Feuer frei! Kleine Fahrt voraus.
Good shot, man. Looks like a tugboat of some kind. I personally don't care. It's a British merchant ship. There we go. Knock him below the waterline. Bring our course to the left a bit to give our gun crew a better solution. Almost not even really worth shooting. Except he knows where we are. And I'm sure he's transporting something or another. Yeah, there goes the lifeboat. Good luck. Sink him quickly before he can get off an SOS. We sank a tugboat. Everyone was beyond ecstatic. first of many, men, the first of many. Let's get the watch crew back on deck. Now they're already on deck. And let's get the hell out of here. Auf Wiedersehen, Tommy. I told you she was transporting things. Alright, how's our fuel look? Yeah, it's good, not great. Let's keep moving. Yeah, I'll give up my 4 knots with that fuel. Actually, let me take a look at how much range we have. Navigation. Ports. Let's get up to speed. Range at this speed. 10,000 kilometers. That would use 3,000. We need 3,000 to get back, so we have 3,000 to patrol. Alright. And that's just playing it safe. That should still give us an extra 2,000 kilometers that we can travel. Whoa. What are you? Ship headed north, slow. Let's see if we can't just try and intercept that. No idea if it'll work, but... Where do we want to go? We want to... Nope. Damn. Stop that. What is this message? Lolome or Bellio, alright. September 12th.
Schiff gesichtet.
Where? 329.
Schiff gesichtet. Lage 329. Große Entfernung.
Where? Three, two, nine. That's 270, that's 300, 329. There. Let's move to right there. All right. I don't much care what she is. Right, gun crew to the deck. Gun crew on deck to the deck.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Feuer einstellen.
Hold your fire. Till we get close enough to, you know, give him a what for. No sense wasting shell for them right now.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Volle Fahrt voraus.
Let's go ahead and catch up with them. Right.
Große Fahrt voraus. Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Feuer frei.
Fire when ready. See if they're even getting close. No, they're not getting close.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Feuer einstellen.
Oh, did they? Oh no, I had a little smoke from one of our shell hits. No, speed it up. He'll just rotate. Do his Michael Jackson dance thing. I think they can run that fast, they just... It's just annoying to catch them, really. We'll catch him now. There we go. Directly on him. I'll chase him down a bit. I don't want to waste any torpedoes on an unescorted merchant while I still have shells left. I don't want to waste any shells that I'm using to attack unescorted merchants.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Feuer frei.
Give another shot. Much better. Looks like a tanker. Oh, everyone's a bit wide. Is it? Oh, just in front. September 12th. There we go, put a few more into them. So this one's at such so far range. Just aim for the hull. Don't even bother with the waterline, you'll never hit it at this angle. And if you do, it'll be because you misjudged your shot at the hull. We're burning fuel rather rapidly, so I'm going to switch it back to standard. Now that we're in range, I think we'll be fine with the whole hitting them thing. And keeping pace with the tanker shouldn't be too hard in a U-boat. Basically a speedboat that can submerge. That must have gone over. That one just went wide. Where's my radio officer? Report. Send a contact report. Bunga. The shots are going kind of wide. I'm curious. There we are. What is the range on this thing? It's over 1,000. It's probably more like, what, 2,000? You think? $1,500. Correcting fire. 1,000's too short. That close is too short. Maybe the other one was short and I just didn't see it. Short. 3,500. I think that one went long. 3,000. Fire again. Just that range down to try and hit them the waterline. Always have fun on the guns. I'll give it back to the gun crew though. Of course you would. There's another shot out. Ooh, right smack in the back. It looks like they're not armed at all. Come on, man. That's just way off. Once they turn broadside to us, we should be able to hit them again. Although I am concerned about our ammo consumption. These bigger ships can soak up a lot of that damage from our cannons. We should be in range of that. Hitting them in the waterline should be a viable tactic.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Auf Wasserlinie zielen.
There we go. That's a good one. Hold them beneath the waterline. My personal hope is that it'll go underneath the waterline, hit them in the props, and they'll stop. We can just sail up right next to them and shoot them. But yeah, this'll work fine. We're nailing them beneath the waterline every single shot. And when they miss, they're hitting the hull. So this is going fine. Good luck, Tommy. So, I'm thinking this isn't a tanker, actually. It's actually a cargo ship of some kind. Not sure what kind, though. Ooh, that was a good hit. Right beneath the command tower. What's it called? The conning tower. The bridge. Right behind the bridge. We got some fire started on border. Nailed her in the hull a few times in some decent places. And she looks like she's about off there. She's still turning though, so we'll just leave our course alone. Our gunners are doing fine. Another fire. Whoa! What was that? Something explode? Something might have exploded. Let my crew keep firing shells, but
Neuer Kurs 347.
I'll admit I'm moderately curious about what's going on board this ship. I'm gonna try and cross over to the other side of it now. Gotta keep an eye out. Sometimes destroyers will sneak up on you while you're doing this. And I just realized I've been super target fixated. So I need to look around and make sure we're not about to get in more trouble than we can handle.
Ein Drittel Fahrt voraus.
Yeah, we'll go ahead at 1/3. She looks like she's listing towards the stern, but I can't tell for sure. A few more holes behind the waterline in the stern should seal her fate. If we can get those, please. I want to take a good look at it. Actually, what is it? Single stack. Got a single stack, two-ish things on top of it. I'm just gonna rapidly click. No. No, no. It's not that. It's not that either. Could be that. Maybe that. Small merchant. No, it's got too many stacks. This'll be good practice for figuring out what his friends are. Not a large cargo either. I know what a large cargo looks like. She stopped missing. No, good shot. It's not a troop transport or a troop ship. Ooh, right down there, that's gotta hurt. Now we've come back full circle. Skipped over it, apparently. See, so it's got a stack in the middle, bridge at the front, and she's going down. I don't know what it is. Either way, I'm gonna divert my course away. Pull the gun crew off station. Gun crew off. Get the watch back up. Get us off that. Navigator. Naval drill nade. Head standard. Unless our head following our course takes us like directly through him, which case, let's go this way. This will be fine. We just want to keep distance in case his ammunition stores or something explode. Or whatever he's carrying. I just don't like to explode, really, is what it boils down to. But yeah, he'll sink slowly. He's taking in water from the stern. But we'll be heading north. He's currently kind of right where he is. And by the time we turn to it, I'm sure we'll be fine. Yeah. Could have been a tramp steamer. I think it was a tramp steamer. By the way, it'll be in the journal, so we can just check that. I'm thinking tramp steamer. I just don't know what that one is. Weird. Yeah, she is taking on water to her stern. Have the radio operator send a I'll send the BTU a patrol report at the end of the day. We're doing great on fuel. This is only the beginning. That one shot must have gone straight into the bridge and killed a lot of the loop. There goes a lot of it. Oh yeah, she's sinking fast now. Stern just flooded in now, it's gonna drag down the top. There goes the bridge. There goes the top bit. Just gonna hang there for a little bit. Navigator, what's our, Yeah, she's got a ways to sink. There she goes. Little oily slick is all that remains. Good job, Minna. Very good job. Now let's hope whoever we pissed off doesn't come and find us and kill us. Take on survivors from the SS Baluji. So the Americans are helping out the British. Oh well, they're helping out the British survivors. It's alright. I'd help out the survivors too if I didn't have orders to shoot them whenever I found them. West, southwest, that's off course. We need to get to our patrol area. So far I haven't seen any lifeboats come off those boats yet. So I'm assuming we've either caught them by surprise or we've shot off their lifeboats with our large gratuitous explosions. I'm going to go check with our weapons officer though and see how many what remains in our stores for our artillery. Hundred and 33 shells. That's alright. Not good. We've only got the steam-powered torpedoes, so... Thank you very much. So we'll continue moving. This AN-14 crossing is the one thing that's really got me paranoid. Because we're going in between Scapa Flow and Lewick. Here's this. When fuel is used up, return north of the Shetlands. Chance to attack warships west over the Orkneys. Operation to position B if possible. So I'm guessing that means when you run out of gas, come around this way. So I plan accordingly to be out of fuel. Looks like the initial blitz of Britain's defenses is going quite well. But how well things are going in Poland. Heard no news of them yet. South-southwest.
Neuer Funkspruch, Herr Kaloin.
U-226, or U-26 is talking about their torpedoes and being generally okay. Who's responding? And the BDU is congratulating them on not being failures. Congratulations! I'm gonna go ahead and adjust this. Try and cut some air distance off my trek. Put an island between me and there. That should save, shave off about a few hundred kilometers, save us some fuel. We'll be hanging in a bit close, but not too close that we can't dive and run away if we get engaged. So that's basically the perfect distance. Just gotta make sure there's no islands along our route. I'm a veteran of Silent Hunter 4, where the islands would pop up mysteriously and sank more U-boats than destroyers ever did. More radio messages. Boats been forced shipping along the line Dungeness, down the mines off St. Captain's Lightship. Alright. Not doing much checking out here in the north, because, honestly, no one should be around. So, the only people who'd be coming out are the Canadians, and it'd be real unlucky if they found me right off here. So we'll just kind of... We'll not be looking for them until we get to grid reference BF-16. Maybe we'll hunt around there. Yeah. Is that a new one? No, I thought they'd sent two in rapid succession. Weird. Also, I turned the music off in the menus, because apparently that blocks it in Germany, because Germans don't like certain kinds of music, I guess? I don't know. Must be a German thing. Ah. It really sucks to be in Area F then. September 13th. 3 more days. Should be about the end of our patrol, actually. Or the end of our infiltration route. All these damn messages. U-27 off the North Channel. Alright, U-27, 30, 29, 33, 53, 28, 31, and 32. Mission Area V. Maybe... bunch of U-boat positioning orders. I bet you we could set up right here in this channel. Just pick up merchants who try and go around, because it looks deep enough. Once we finish up here in a BF-16, I'll give that a shot. But I do know St. George's channel isn't as channely as you think it might be. Warship, medium speed. Moving away. If he's moving away, it's at long range. Bearing a 354. So up. Yeah, unless we see him, I'll not be worried. It does look like we've stumbled upon what looks to be...
Jawohl, Herr Kaloy.
Trill meters per second towards the south. No, towards the east. Ah, demon noise. Don't know where that came from. It totally wasn't a Google thing. Definitely not that. Wind speed 12 meters per second. Direction 83. Precipitation number. It's just bad waves. Well, as long as we don't... Warship is freaking me out, man. As long as we don't see him, I'll be fine. Extension to operations area seems promising as recommended. I'm gonna go ahead and... There we are. Could I have your job real quick? No? Alright, cool. You sure I couldn't just, like, squeeze in there? Alright, you got that. You have fun. Alright, bye. I'm sure he'll be fine. Yeah, there's warships up north. Fauna head. But not head. Yeah, all the ships were sinking. They're kind of having a bad day. September 14th, it seems. What radio messages? U-35. Jesus Christ, man. You can't go through the channel. Do you know how much... They were attacked by airplanes and a British submarine. You just can't do that, man. Here we should have near unlimited depth and thus unlimited protection for quite some time. Looks like U-39 got smashed, really. They got hit by 3 destroyers, took a lot of damage. They surfaced, they blew ballast and are abandoning the ship. Damn. Alright, let's get this thing moving. Let's get to our patrol area, quickly. Lots of radio messages. The Ida Bach has taken 42 crew members from Britain on board. There's a mosquito in here. I need to kill that bastard. Did I just get a radio message? U-31. Just arrived. B-1719. Right about... 171... Not right about there, actually. So we're a little bit late getting on station, but we've... Whoa, what? Okay.
Schiff gesichtet. Lage 2. Große Entfernung.
Cool. What's the degree of change? We're going perpendicular to it. Going that way. We want to head south-ish.
Jawohl, Herr Kalon. Neuer Kurs 195.
Increase speed to full. Turn it down. Turn in towards it. Yeah. Don't you worry, we'll come and get you for you. Right, that'll work. Gun crew to the deck. Actually, do we have a setting for this? Yeah, whatever. Foy.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Große Fahrt voraus.
Fire whenever you feel like it.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Feuer frei.
You guys know they can fire, right? Dude, gun crew's not firing for some reason. I'll take over. Alright, looks like they're about 2,000 out. File one. Back two. Shot.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Ein Drittel Fahrt voraus.
Gonna keep holding them below the waterline. Gonna fire a shell at 1,000, try and get some nicks in below the waterline. Come on.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Kleine Fahrt voraus.
Yeah, that's good. Goes under, hits them. Goes under, hits them. Yeah, you're having a real shitty day, aren't you? Keep that gun pointed low. Try and hold him in the stern some. Let's try and get him in the bow. Oh wow, that's close. We're down to 500 elevation. Trying to hit him in the bow to slow him down. Because if we hit him in the front, they'll just drive the water straight in. That should do it.
Come on, Yamin! Yamin!
I don't know what that one is. Looks like a medium cargo, I think. Maybe a small cargo. By the way, you've been hit by a U-boat. Send my regards to Churchill. Fat bastard. And our course is on a heading of something.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Gehen wieder auf Kurs, Herr Kaloin.
I think it's to the right, so we'll just go ahead and resume our course. Good spot. Good spot indeed, gentlemen. A fine prize. Teach those, I guess, Canadians. We kind of blew the flag off with the first shot. Guessing British could be Canadians. It'll teach whoever that is to not come back around here anymore. Now we'll just watch a sink. I like to watch them sink. But yeah, a few good shots below the waterline will do. It'll work horrors on a merchant ship, but wonders for a U-boat crew. Well, you know, waterline on the merchant ship. Don't hold me up below the water. You know what I mean. And that's at 7 o'clock, August 14th. Well, I guess it's more 6 o'clock here. We haven't even been intercepted by any destroyers yet, which is really nice. Of course, we haven't seen any convoys yet, which is... I mean, it's alright. There's good rewards to convoys, though. You find a lot of ships all in one place. You can take about 2 of them at once. If you do it right. You can take 4 if you're really good. I've seen it happen before. And you're lucky, and you get a lot of small ships. So you can take, like, 4 small ones if you're that good. But normally, I'll try and pick out the 2 biggest ones. Or if the convoy is, like, really close, and I don't have that much time, I'll pick up just the biggest one and fire some torpedoes, maybe a spread of other torpedoes. But, 2 ships is a pretty decent average haul. Yeah, there she goes. You can tell she's sinking. Her bow is already up in the air. Her stern's sinking for sure. I just always kind of like watching him sink, so I don't know. It's nice. Probably the wrong word to use for that, but it's interesting, I guess. It'd be the right word. So yeah, it's been about an hour now. God, we've got to go 2 more days. So yeah. These weeks might take more than an hour, I guess. Expect an hour and 30 minutes. Episodes with action. 2 hours if we're getting hunted. Go ahead and speed this up a bit. Once the bow gets below, it's pretty much all over. And now she'll just start chugging. You'll see her just jump underwater. As the bow fills with water and it just swallows it whole. Sometimes that last little bit will sit up there, like it is right now. It's filled with air, but even it too must sink. Right. Good job, gentlemen. That'll bring to a close day 14. Put our course there, then we'll plot a patrol course for that. Sometimes it's the... Another radio message. Want to cross speed 10 knots.
Neuer Funkspruch, Herr Kaloin.
I don't know if that's actually true or not. T-52 Cumberland Group. No, it doesn't say which grid, which one. so I don't know if I can even find it, even if it was real. Either way, we're probably too far away for it to make much of a difference anyway. So, it's 7 o'clock. I'm guessing someone found the convoy. The FD is ordering U-boats in the vicinity to engage the convoy. The Führer, the Unterseeboats, I guess.
Neuer Funkspruch, Herr Kaloin.
Requesting leave to call in Reykjavik to land a seriously wounded man. Light damage to bows, 2 tubes out of action, 2 captured Air Force officers on board. What are you doing up near Reykjavik? Checking a hoop. But yeah, I guess. Alright. I don't know. Something got attacked by some airplanes. Shot the airplanes down. But one guy got shot while doing it. Must be the response. I'm curious. Nah, it's a Cheyenne. She's sinking. And right, read message. Message Cheyenne. The Atabaka is just jumping around saving people. It's like they don't even have cargo to deliver. They're just hanging out, saving people. It's like 80 people from various ships on board them now. Right, we should reach there about east northeast. You might run right into them. It's definitely possible. Radio message. All right.
Neuer Funkspruch, Herr Kaloin.
Looks like U-30's got permission to go to Reykjavik. And they're gonna drop off that wounded guy, then they're gonna RTB afterwards. So many radio messages. Shuhat. Oh. That's close by. Alright, brief detour. Let's see if we can find him.
Schiff gesichtet.
Knew I could find him. 040.
Schiff gesichtet. Lage 4-4. Große Entfernung.
Alright. Zero, 4-4.
Schiff gesichtet.
Yeah, I get it. Where is he?
Schiff gesichtet.
No shit, that's long range.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Neuer Kurs.
Well, he's shifting right. Which means we should shift to about 40. Should put us on there. Whoa. I'm seeing 2 ships. Who's the other guy? Yeah, a tanker and a cargo. still dark enough? Maybe. I definitely got somebody out. They're out directly that way. Alright, let's which way are we pointed? We are pointed at 1-2. So spool around here. Find 1-2, 1-2-0. Looks like we're headed that way. Ish. Ship should be around there. I feel like they're headed east-northeast, which is about that way. So about this way is about the right way to go. I think. Should bring us closer. If we move into position quickly, we could hit them simultaneously with a torpedo attack. That's a tanker, we know for sure. That's a cargo ship of some kind. I don't want to risk getting a protracted gun battle this close to England. No, not that close. We're still within range, technically. Let's see how close we can get ourselves. Before daybreak. I gotta restart the sound. Go ahead and try and identify these guys. You are a tanker. Now he has three masts. One in the front, one in the back, smokestack in the back. Okay, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, maybe 3. It could be that too. He's got the bridge right there. Need to be a bit closer. Yeah. That's who you are. No, it's not him because he has the little square right there that matches this little square. Looks like we're seeing him from an angle. Right. There's no way in hell I'm going to be able to identify that guy from this range. He's got a midway stack. We do have a relatively big target. In fact, two at the tanker and one at the merchant. A lot of rush to get in front of them. How are we doing everything else? It's definitely medium tanker. Alright.
Neuer Kurs 7-4.
Right. Bring us to an easterly course. Where are they at right now? Crap. They're basically sitting still. I don't know, I wonder what the range is on them. $5,000 to $7,000. I'm gonna open up the handbook again. The handbook. Flip through my pages and find the guy so I can see exactly how tall he's supposed to be and where. I think the other one in front is a small merchant. Come on.
Große Fahrt voraus.
Medium tanker. He is 28 feet tall at the top of the middle mast. Alright. $5,000 meters tall. 6,000 range, about 6,000. Come on, there you are. 56,000. Angle off bow. We are to his port, about 92 degrees. Speed time. 2, 3, 4, 5. What's the speed? Knots doesn't make much sense. Then again, we are going 14 knots.
Alle Maschinen stopp. Neuer Kurs.
Right. Do the speed again. Do it again. Do it for 15 seconds this time. We must have gotten closer. 53. Angle off bow. We're a bit in front of him. Just enough to see down him. Speed, time it again. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 7 knots. That sounds reasonable. Right.
Rohr 1, los, Aal ist im Wasser. Rohr 2, los, Aal ist im Wasser.
Tubes 1 and 2 away. Appear the tracking. No, not tracking, but that going. It's completely possible I thoroughly screwed this up. I've not done it in a long time. Shazer. Crap. I'm gonna keep taking range notes. Alright. Could be behind him, to be honest. Let's take a look at which way he's going. Damn, put behind him. So I have my angle on Bao wrong. Think about that much, it's about 108 degrees port. Time to speed again. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 8 knots, alright. One more range measurement. It's wrong. That's right. Alright.
Rohr 3, los! Aal ist im Wasser!
This is more out of my desire to get practice with torpedoes than anything else. I'm not gonna hit either. Damn, what am I doing wrong? Time that speed again. Oh, that's right. Five off there. Hang on a second. No, that doesn't zoom in any better. I'm trying to find out what I'm doing wrong, so when I attack a convoy, I know what I'm doing. But all those torpedoes missed for some reason. We're definitely behind him now. About the 45 degree mark. Time to speed again. 4, 5, 6, 9, 10, not sure, whatever.
Rohr 4, los, Aal ist im Wasser.
I want to fire one more, just because I'm thinking I kind of know how he's going now. But I am firing too many torpedoes at a ship that's not worth it. Now that angle's off too. Let's see, would it be... Shut off several torpedoes there. Zero. No, it's about there. It's pretty much about... 8 or so. Right, they're evading.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Neuer Kurs, 9-9. Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Große
Fahrt voraus. That sucked. Get those torpedoes loaded. We'll just go ahead and sink the tanker with our deck gun. We've got enough shells. God, I'm sorry for that, guys. That was horrible. I need to go revisit the tutorial on how to do that. Because I know I can do it. I've done it a million times. Although my guess is that they spotted us and sped up from 8 knots. Because I wasn't exactly the most sneaky U-boat commander ever. By the way, they sure as hell know we're here now. All right, let's stop throwing shells like willy-nilly.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Feuer einstellen.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Volle Fahrt voraus.
All right, now let's start throwing shells willy-nilly again.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Große Fahrt voraus.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Feuer frei.
Stop the willy-nilly gang again. Where'd he go? Could you guys not miss? I wonder how far away they are now. You count that as the base. Doesn't really make that much difference though, it's about 200 meters. I don't really know. I don't really know why those torpedoes missed. They could have been evading, but they all looked like they went to the side. Main problem I have is I couldn't see where the heck they went at all. Jeez, something exploded over there. Start a few big fires on her. Try and close rapidly. And since it's a tanker, we'll just, fire at the hull. No, come on.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Auf Rumpfziel.
Because if we just hit the hull, we should ignite the fuel, or whatever is on board it. And that could just completely explode. Which would really be bad for the tanker crew. Pretty good for me. Save me some ammo. Shell missed. Hmm. Wager it's a small merchant. Ooh, right in the bridge. Yeah, that's definitely a small tanker. It's really annoying. I thought I had the torpedo attack worked out pretty well, too. I might turn that weapon off so it tips back on and do the calculations myself, but then have the right answer presented to me. Just to see what I did wrong. There goes that bit. Come on, men, keep up the good fire. Right there, that should start a fire. It did. Once we get a few big fires going, I'll let her sort of simmer and switch over to that ship. What? Wrong one. Large merchant tugboat. Alright. I thought it was a different button. I'm looking for the, HGKL. I guess that's not any of those. I'm looking for the weapons management screen so I can figure out how much ammo I have left. Seven shots. 35 meters. Okay, they're closer than I thought. That's one way to refine the range for torpedo. I'll just put a few really good rounds right into the middle of it right there. That should set something on fire. Right in the middle. Maybe even get a good explosion out of it. So now if you poke a gas can with the hot air enough times, it'll explode. Oh shit. They're gonna say that about four times. This game's gonna rub it in my face. Then again, I'm better at strategy, not tactical stuff. I did think I knew how to aim torpedoes. Try and decrease that elevation down there. Pump a few below the waterline in there. There we go, that's a good one. Alright. I'm just gonna continue this fire as fast as possible now. Pretty much in the same place too. Put a few in the back. These ships are tough, these big ones. That's why I like to sink them with torpedoes. There's about two torpedoes, at least put one in a critical state. on, just sink already. Fire it down to 45.
Rohr 1, feuerbereit, Herr Kaloin.
Haha, got her. Let's,
neuer Kurs 5-9.
Let's try about, just about 10 neuer degrees.
7-7.
Just a bit out of the way of that tanker that's kind of on fire. So I'm guessing it's not going to be very happy when it explodes. Ooh. Dang, that really must have hurt. So we're out 4 torpedoes, several rounds of cannon ammunition. I'm gonna get those boys to hit the waterline on that ship.
Auf Wasserlinie zielen. Ein Drittel Fahrt voraus. Neuer Kurs 7-4. Große Fahrt voraus.
Go ahead, standard. So yeah, lots of gunplay this time around. Let's go ahead and check up on how much ammo we've got. ...37 shells. This might be the last true gun attack we make before we're stuck making torpedo attacks and finishing off with the cannon. And we can't afford to waste many more shells. So...
Ein Drittel Fahrt voraus.
I'm just gonna keep pounding it in the back. Try and save at least 20 something rounds.
Kleine Fahrt voraus. Alle Maschinen stoppen.
Yeah. Spreading in several locations. Fortunately, I don't know the ship type well enough to know if she's riding low yet or not. So yeah, lots of engagement. It's about an hour and 45 minutes long. I'll always do these in one part, so I won't ever do this in a two-part thing, so however long it is, it's however much action happens. Ah! Sehr gut, sehr gut. Ooh! My god! What are they doing? Transporting chickens. Let's go due east.
Neuer Kurs 8-9. Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Große Fahrt voraus.
God, that one... I kind of expected that from the tanker, not from... from whatever that was. It must be an ammunition ship or something. Jeez. Let's go off 20 degrees. Actually, we want to go due south. About 150. Anyway. Good God, that ship exploded. Now let's make turns for BF-16. Good God, man. Talk about a ship I don't want to be on. Configure for surface cruise. I'll swap out some of these guys. Swap on my engine compartment team. Okay, that'll work. Good God, man. Whatever you were carrying, it sure packed a punch. Bye, tanker. She'll just keel over on her left from all that holes in the waterline. And there she goes. I'll speed it up so we can get on to our destination. Always let that one last little bit play out in real time. It's almost a little bit scary watching that kind of ship go down. We'll go ahead and finish this up at 1/3 just for timing reasons and such. The city of Paris is calling an SOS. Put that back up there. Get over here. And being that I'm going to end it today, I'll just end it once we get to a grid reference BF-16. What's this? Ship going northeast. We'll ignore it for the time being. Oh, here we are. Well, gentlemen, this has been an eventful week. We've started a war, and started our career. I'll see you all next week, and we continue with whatever we've started. I'll see you all then. Till then, I've been your Kaloin Tomato. I bid you good week.